Well, welcome back. So in this lecture, we'll look into the concept called frames. One of the most important concepts in the Selenium, WebDriver, and also from interview point of view, this was a very famous question. The interviewer definitely cracks this question because this is one of the advanced concepts, and you know, he can justify the people with the answers they give on this concept. So let's learn this clearly. So first of all, what is frames? So to keep in a short, frames are a kind of HTML documents which are embedded on other HTML document. For example, so this Google is a home page. Okay, this is the web page. So frames are nothing but I will put other HTML document on the same page. So page on the page. Okay, so the particular subsection HTML document, we call it as frames. So why do we use it in general? So why developers basically use the frames on site? So the main reason is, if you take one news website, so it have the home page with all setup with every links about their state and the central news. But if you find there is something called breaking news section, which news will be updated for every 5 minutes or 1 hour, there will be scrolling, right? So those part is frames. That means without modifying or without reloading the entire web page, a developer can work on particular section and can modify it, and at the same time he can commit the changes. So without disturbing the and reloading the whole page. So that is the reason, if there is something which is dynamic in the page, if you find there is some section which is dynamic in the page, so developer always prefer to write it as a separate HTML document and he will embed it on the existing document. So basically we say that as frames. From Selenium perspective, to handle that frames, you cannot do it in a traditional way. So whenever you navigate to this page, so Selenium will have the information about this entire web page, but not on the HTML document which is embedded on this page. Okay, it cannot, you know, basically it cannot traditionally identify the elements on that particular frame. If you want to identify those elements in that frame, you need to do some mechanism, you need to write some kind of coding which makes us to automate the particular frame. So how to automate that frames and where do we find that, we'll see in our next session. Okay, thank you.